This is the Plank flying wing, designed by Mike Whittaker. It's mostly made from wood with aluminium tubular spars and steel undercarriage with glass pultruded rods for the suspension. Pitch and roll are controlled by large elevons on the trailing edge of the wing and yaw by drag tips on the fins. And here's the designer, Mike Whittaker, who is now in his 80s and has designed, well, at least 9 different aeroplanes in the MW series. Let's take it for a spin. That's Tony Bryars there, waiting to record everything on video. This is Mike's right-hand man, Andy, who's just about to pull start the engine.
Okay, clear prop!
You'll notice from the windsock there's quite a crosswind, 9 knots, gusting to about 14 at something like 30 degrees to the runway. I had intended just to do a few hops, but as soon as it was in the air, it felt immediately very stable. So rather than risk the airframe, I carried on into a climb. Nice gentle control inputs to start with until I've discovered whether it's fully stable or not. In fact, it flies just like any other aeroplane, really. There's no hint that it is a flying wing. It doesn't have poor pitch stability and no tendency to oscillate in pitch. Towards the airfield so that we're always within gliding distance, and we'll be heading into wind as we cross the runway. It runs out of elevator authority and so there's no real stall. We've reached full backstick and it's just mushing along. That annoying thing that keeps coming into shot just above my head is the top of the canopy. I'm a bit tall for the cockpit. Mike's a bit shorter than me, and he, of course, designed it for himself. Not making much progress into the headwind, but we're doing about 60 miles an hour. Some turns coming up, left and right. One drawback of wearing a head cam, of course, is that it tends to smooth out the manoeuvres. I lean my head the opposite way in a turn, for instance. Next I'll try some yawing. There's a very small amount of Dutch roll. Dive and a zoom coming up. Now a dive to VNE of around 90 miles per hour. Low-level pass down the runway for Tony's camera. And a tight circuit before landing. Look at that weird shadow on the ground. I'll just reposition to bring it back into shot. Trying to land across the runway to reduce the crosswind. But there was no need, it copes very well with crosswind.
I ran out of energy just before touching down, and it touched down harder than I expected. A little blip of throttle would have been the thing to do. Well, it flies just like any other aeroplane, really, doesn't it? It does need the trim, though. It was
You're pulling now,
constant back force, yes, on the stick.